In this video, I want to explain the damage for ductile metals material model FLD damage. Before we continue the video, I want to encourage you to subscribe to my channel. According to the analytics of YouTube, only about 20% of the viewers are subscribed to my channel, which is very few. So please use the subscribe button and the like button to help the channel out. In addition, you have here in the video description a GitHub link which has the repository of all my UMATs with Abaqus input files, and here you can also find other repositories, and then you can see here timecodes for the video and also my Google Scholar profile. My Google Scholar profile includes all my papers, including the citation count. Support my channel by citing my papers. I want to hit 1000 citations in 2022. Okay, now let's go back to the main video. FLD stands for forming limit diagram, and in this forming limit diagram we have the major principal strain versus the minor principal strain, and then we get a forming limit curve, the FLC. Okay, so what is the FLC? The FLC is basically a material parameter curve describing the limits of forming for metal sheets. And the main points are that we have here 1 uniaxial tension, then 2 plane strain, and 3 equi-biaxial tension. So you can see here for uniaxial tension we have the major principal strain is positive, so here, and the minor principal strain is negative, so compression basically. And in the plane strain configuration we have a major principal strain, but the minor principal strain is 0. And in the equi-biaxial tension state we have equal minor and major principal strain. Okay, so what is the application? Obviously it's material characterization, then formability analysis. It's basically required for steel and aluminium suppliers, and it is also often used in the automotive industry. Okay, so how does the testing procedure work? There's in Germany an ISO 1204, and according to this ISO we use metal sheets with a thickness of 0.3 mm to 4 mm thickness. And then there's a certain test, the Nakajima test, where we put a flat metal sheet and deform it by a hemispherical punch from below. So this is basically a side view and this is from top. So we have here the metal sheet in the machine, and from the bottom there comes a mechanical hemispherical punch with a certain speed, and then the metal sheet fractures and the corresponding strains are plotted in the FLC. And now a short video of the testing procedure. Okay, and according to the DIN ISO 1204, we need at least 5 different geometries, like shown here, for example uniaxial tension, plane strain and biaxial tension, and the geometries in between. And for each geometry, we need at least 3 specimens. So it works basically like this, we take one geometric configuration of the metal sheet, and then we test the geometry 9 times, and then we get obviously 9 different values, and then we calculate the mean value of this geometric configuration, and then we plot the mean values of each of the 8 geometric configurations, and then we get the FLC. And here is another example, and those values represent the input for Abaqus. Okay, now we are here in Abaqus. Here are the values from the presentation. And then we go to the property module. Then basically create a new material, mechanical, and then here damage reductive methods, FLD damage. And then we just paste here the values. And the complete model description would look like this. We have here the FLD damage parameters, damage evolution, density, elastic parameters and plastic parameters. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and until next time.